All right, Dan, come on in. Where did you used to do this?
I used to work in a gym, and then later into a rehab clinic, a chiropractic clinic inside of a gym, and we did body fat testing inside the clinic.
Oh. How many times have you done this?
Well over 100.
Oh. Mm-hmm.
Now, granted, not with calipers that nice.
What did you use? Like the plastic ones that would pinch?
Yeah, just a plastic crappy one.
This thing isn't zeroed out to zero.
No, I'm going to factor that in, so no worries.
Well, does this not change it?
I tried messing with it earlier, but it seemed easier just to...
I loosened it. I went up. Now it's at 2.
Just tighten it back down. I'll take out the difference.
Oh, wait a minute. What about this? If I loosen it and then push the calipers. Yeah. Oh, that's not... There, that's almost zeroed out.
All right,
what are you going to do first?
I need 3 sites. I need your thigh, your abdomen, and chest. So it's up to you.
All right. Well, just come over here. Can get you some.
Where do you do chest? Center? Side?
No, it's actually about inch and a half to the side of the nipple.
Okay. Yeah.
So sort of in between shoulder and nipple.
All right. Come get some. Mm-hmm. Hold on a second. Where's the two-way? What is it?
I was just going to tell you, when you get done with all this, Cooperman called me, and I'll give you an update.
All right. Let's start here?
Yeah. Okay. Go up on your toe, so you're not flexing your quad.
Okay. Is that what you want?
Yeah.
All right.
Is this inner thigh?
No. It's the front of my leg.
Yeah, okay, front of the leg.
What are you doing?
I'm trying to get a good grip.
All right.
Squeeze.
I know.
I don't know.
Okay.
And you take 3 and then you average them?
What?
Quit pulling your shirt up.
Yeah, take 3 and average them.
Okay. All right, here. Get you some nipple.
All right. Let your right arm hang.
Okay.
Are you flexing?
No.
It's very nice.
Ah.
Painful.
Huh?
It looks painful.
Well, it is. And he's got to leave it on for a second so it'll pinch into the skin and get a final reading.
God, you're like me out here. Okay.
Got it?
Yeah.
Turn your head. I got to pull my stomach out.
Oh, I have to look when you have your wiener out. But for your stomach, I have to turn away?
Yeah. I get some.
How often do you shave?
Why?
Your tummy. I just wondered.
It ain't totally shaved. Stop looking at it.
Well,
it's your stomach. Quit it. I trim it. Otherwise, I look burly. Nobody likes a bear. I'm in between a bear and a twink.
You're both a little closer to the bear than you are the twink.
All right.
Now what do you got
to
do?
I just need to...
You going to the other room?
I just need a calculator too on my computer.
Oh.
Oh, I have one right here. You're going to do it right here?
I don't know how to use it.
You can take the bike back.
Okay, well.
It ain't going to be under 13%.
You were pretty close before, and I think you've lost some fat just in the last 2 weeks. What do you have in your face?
Well.
Hang on, I got to find it.
What are you looking for?
The calculator on my computer. It's up right now.
Nah, dead air is okay here. Build the tension. Do we have a mask or something I can wear in case...
I'm sure we can find something.
Because I didn't bring anything. Well?
10.5.
It ain't 10.5!
That's plus or minus 3%. So you're probably more like about 12.
13.
No, you're more like 12.
Oh, so we don't know for sure. Because you're guessing. You said plus or minus 3%.
Plus or minus 3% would still have you within the range.
Yeah, you're still in.
And you haven't calculated for my age.
That is true.
All right, so it could actually be more.
It would be leaner.
No, it wouldn't.
Yes.
No, it would be more.
Oh.
So this is not accurate.
It's as accurate as it can.
Yes, it is. As accurate as it's going to be.
Well, it's not as accurate as if Kevin came down and did it. If we're just guessing, why didn't we just say, hey, you know what? Your body fat's 10%. Go ride naked.
O'Malley used to do this.
You're supposed to have some kind of booklet.
You don't have to have a booklet. You just need to factor in the variable for the age bracket.
See?
You came in 10 and a half. Go ride.
I'm not riding anything.
Go ride.
We don't know for sure.
The age is only going to affect it by a couple of percentage points.
And that could be enough to push it back to 13%. And my body fat's not 10%. I'm fat.
You're not fat. God.
I ain't going until he calculates in my age.
Okay.
Okay, I calculated in your age.
Nice try.
12%.
Call, why don't you get somebody from Larry North to come down here?
They could.
It's not that far from South Lake to here.
Yeah. Dexter or Matt or Kevin or somebody.
Yeah, Rob, call somebody from Larry North. I ain't riding until you guys are...
No, you need to do it. Not Welsh.
All right, what's the Cooperman thing?
He called and said that he would speak to you on or off the air, whichever you preferred. He wanted to set you straight. Your facts are a little skewed.
About him wasting 15, 20 minutes bitching about me and my parking spot today in a sales meeting.
Yeah, I just suggested that he apologize and use that as the, you know, opening to speak with you. Basically, hey, Russ, I apologize. Like to, you know, let you know exactly what took place in the meeting. And he didn't like that idea. He said, I'm not going to apologize. Just let him know. I'll talk to him if he wants to.
Are you calling back and reminding the instructions I gave him with the mics off and telling him to sit on that one?
Yes, sir.
Do I have any of the facts wrong?
The only thing that could be wrong is maybe the time, because when she was telling me, it was just like, just kind of spitting it out, and I don't know, I didn't ask, say, hey, how long did you guys talk about it? You were just saying like...
But it was a topic of a sales meeting.
Absolutely, yes.
And they're all having a fit about it.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. I hope this little pissy issue about this parking spot and me having it is going to be worth all the grief that's going to come from this.
I know. I'm sure it's not, but at this point, what is he going to do?
Well, he comes back and says, you know what? I'm sorry I was being a chick about the whole thing.
That would solve the
question. I shouldn't have said anything. My bad.
That'd be the stand-up thing to do.
No, he's not going to do that. He's going to get cocky about it. That's what happened. He went upstairs and he said, all right, you know what? Now I'm away from him. He can't get at me. I'm going to cop an attitude.
Right.
He didn't have an attitude when he came in here.
Not at all. Mm.
And he thinks I can't reach him from here. That's the bad news about this, Cooperman. You can't go any place where I can't reach you. And I ain't riding that bike.
Why? 10.5, the bike is here.
Mm-mm.
O'Malley used to do this for a living.
O'Malley also said you got to go back in and calculate age.
Well, let's find
body
out.
Fat for a 24-year-old and a 44-year-old ain't the same. You don't, for whatever reason, it's not calculated the same.
Okay. The reason why is because you would have lesser testosterone levels, therefore having less muscle mass. That's the difference in the factor.
I don't understand. I know it should make sense and I should get it, but I don't.
The older you are, the more difficult that the less testosterone you have in your system. Obviously,
right.
You and I have completely different testosterone levels.
Is this going to be a caveman thing?
No, not at all.
Clearly, old man, I have much more testosterone than you ever dreamed of having. I just thought I'd help you out there.
You're in your waning years, old man.
Yes.
Your balls don't work as well. Your nipples have shriveled.
Pathetic.
What is it, Rob?
Sorry about that. Kevin is in his ball class. They're going to pull him out right now. I'm trying to get him on the phone.
All right, well, you can send the veal guy from Honda, you can send him back to the shop.
Let's just see what Kevin says first.
Yeah, good idea. Okay.
We need a break?
Yeah.
When did we come out of the last one?
4:55.
Did you finish news?
No.
Oh, all right, hold on. Yes, Mike?
Hey, the billboards have that on the side of the road that change three different ads.
Yeah.
They now have a box van that has the same thing. The comical part is they have WB's news team on the back of it. They have the chief meteorologist, if you're behind the van, looking right at you. But Crazy Eye Fred, they've got him positioned just right where his both pupils look like they're going the same direction, but he's looking at about 11 o'clock.
Ah, that's Photoshop.
Yeah.
The only time his eyes line up is during some type of, it's like an eclipse. That ain't.
Well, that's what I was saying. I think they position him just right so that his pupils do line up.
Yeah, they put his head on the corner of the billboard. That way, the eyes look each way.
This is the Russ Martin Show.
How long is it?
I can cut it down for you. It's about four paragraphs, but I'll make it two.
It's stuff like this is exactly the reason that I have a call screener.
Yes, and a handgun.
Yeah.
Somebody sat down and wrote this. A letter from Opossum Paul.
Okay.
Dear Human with Light.
You want no music?
That'd be nice.
Oh, I'm sorry.
All right. Yes. All right. Dear Human with Light, I've thought of this message to you because of our meeting a week ago. The other humans never seemed to notice me. Perhaps they all saw me as just another marsupial. I watched you. You watched me when I climbed the tree. Perhaps one evening soon, you'd like to join me in the trees. After you've enjoyed enough of those liquid objects you frequently hold with your opposable thumbs. I apologize if I...
All right, so this possum doesn't know what the objects I'm holding with my opposable thumbs are, no. But he knows what email is.
Apparently.
All right.
I apologize if I or any of the creatures of my species have caused any apprehension or undue stress to the creature you call Clo. I would not harm you or your friends. However, when I have food for my family, I find it difficult to think about anything else than the warmth of my mate and my home.
Go to the last sentence.
It is my hope that our relationship will continue to be one of you looking at me and me looking at you and us both saying, wow, can you believe we're here? However, if the time comes I need to relocate, then I'm sure it will be by the company of good humans with a kind heart for other creatures. Yours truly, the Opossum Paul.
Let me see that. I just thought it was something he cut and pasted from another website.
No. That came to me. That wasn't even an email. That was actually came in an envelope.
So, oh, he mailed it?
Yeah, he mailed that.
Oh, I got it in an email.
No, he sent the actual hard copy to me. Obviously, he knows about the post office, too. Mm-hmm. I don't know.
All right. Did you want it?
No, thanks.
All right. You ready to go with news?
Sure. Lots of it.
I also got... is anybody interested in the demo tape that Jody Dean put together to get the morning job at K-Love?
He put a bear trick together?
Yeah.
After being in this market for 30 years or 20 years, whatever it is?
Yeah. Where'd you get it?
Is this a new air check?
Yeah. What, Dan?
Where did you get it?
Mm-hmm.
How?
Hmm? Mm. Why do you want
to
know?
I'm just curious. I don't know. Maybe he sent it to you or...
Mm-mm-mm. Yeah, I'd like to hear it.
As far as I know, nobody else has heard this except the people over at K-Love.
Okay.
It's about 10 minutes. You want to hear some of it?
Yeah, sure.
Yeah. What?
Why would he have to send an air check? They know what he sounds like. They've heard him on the radio.
He's never done his own morning show.
Well, true.
He's read news. Written? He's written news.
Written news.
He's written and read news.
He had a talk show for a while in Carol D.
Was it a talk show?
It was morning kind of talk, yeah.
I thought they did news.
A little bit of both.
All right. He's never done this type of show on his own.
Okay. True.
But you're right. Why would you audition? I wouldn't. If I lost this job tomorrow,
yeah.
There's no way I'd send out an audition tape.
Well, you wouldn't have to.
It's belittling. Like having a...
Al Pacino or somebody?
Yeah. Come in and audition.
Audition for a part. No.
We're just going to play along here and see what happens. 98.7 KLLI. 5 minutes past 6 o'clock on Monday morning. Jody Dean at 98.7 KLLI. See, I can't even get the call letters right.
Well...
What?
It's early in the morning. No.
I'd have cut that out.
I'd have cut that one out. Yeah. If it's a didn't really happen on the air, obviously this happened in the production studio.
Yeah.
Don't you go back and change that?
He's probably thinking, you know what? I'm going to give you Jody Dean.
Okay.
And you take Jody Dean wrong. This will be no polished Jody Dean. This will be no edited Jody Dean. Gotcha. This is a sheer talent of Jody Dean.
Wrong. Can't wait to hear the rest.
We're just going to play along here.
All right.
And see what happens. 98.7 KLLI. 5 minutes past 6 o'clock on Monday morning. Jody Dean at 98.7 KLLI. See, I can't even get the call letters right to begin with. But I will get the levels right.
How to cut that out.
Thank you. Some folks are
born Miami. That'd have been enough for me.
That'd have been.
I don't misunderstand. I like Jody.
I do, too.
I just think he's a pompous God schmooker. And I can say that because since he's found God, he forgives people for me, people like me for crap like that.
Yes, he does.
98.7 KLLI, Jody Dean on a Monday morning. And don't forget, Friday, we announce the lineup for this year's Arbor Days. Galveston, oh, yeah. 98.7 KLLI, Jody Dean, a Monday morning. They say 72 degrees for the high this afternoon. This is the kind of weather chambers of commerce brag about.
There is. What does that mean?
It's going to be a beautiful day. I'll transcribe for you.
I don't think I need it.
Okay.
You did. Let's see, what can I add over here?
A house
.7 KLLI, Jody Dean, a Monday morning. Congratulations to the Arlington Bowie girls basketball team. Won the 5A title statewide yesterday. And it was about 25 years ago. This song was number one, and Pascal was playing Cashmere.
Well, I'm running down.
98.7 KLLI, Jody Dean, a Monday morning. Yeah, it was,
This is the Russ Martin Show.
Oh, what was the suck fest you were talking about during the break?
Oh, when Ron Chapman today passed the baton of the morning show at KLLI over to Jody Dean. We have the audio someplace. Rob had it. It was just like...
Here? Was it bad?
It, you know, Chapman in his sappiest moment, and then you had Jody Dean in there tearing up, literally, at one moment, and then they go into a song. It's just, it's a perfect picture of a Ron Chapman, Jody Dean moment.
All right. What time do you do this?
It's morning about 7 something.
This is a dramatic turning point right here because something is about to happen that has not happened in a whole lot of years. I am about to announce the person who will replace me. And there have been a lot of people who spent their radio time waiting for me to either fall over, get dragged out in a rubber bag, or decide to not do it anymore so that they could step into that slot. No one has done it more thoroughly and understudied better, and nobody has been more patient than one of the people that I am about to introduce to you today. Opening the mic to you right now and say that, ladies and gentlemen, it makes all the...
I respect Ron Chapman.
Uh-huh.
I believe I actually love the man.
Mm-hmm.
But I can't take this.
Well, it gets better when Jody comes on.
That I am about to introduce to you today, opening the mic to you right now and say that, ladies and gentlemen, it makes all the sense in the world. It's altogether appropriate. And it's also pretty exciting.
I don't even care. If I'd have been sitting in the car, there's nothing that would have kept me there.
Give me some Buckinghams and shoosh.
Yeah. Where's Harold Melvin in the Blue Notes? Ron.
Well, fill me up, Buttercup.
Yeah, just do something.
I'm in traffic.
Ladies and gentlemen, it makes all the sense in the world. It's altogether appropriate. And it's also pretty exciting. I have said for some time that for every Johnny Carson, there is a Jay Leno who is waiting in the wings and has spent his entire life preparing to take over that shot. When Johnny Carson stepped out, Jay Leno did, and guess what? The ratings went up. How about that? Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the 98.7 K-Lub Studio, Mr. Jody Dean.
Yeah.
Yes. Boy, does this make sense. Hi, Jode. How
you
are you?
You like me. You really like me.
Yes. Yes, after all this time.
Yeah.
It's now been proven. Now, listen, the question is this. You're a television star. You're a pretty big deal. You put on makeup and sat next to Karen Borda. You know? I mean, you got a pretty good life going. Why do you want to...
No, just that's what we were all hearing in our heads. You just made it loud.
Me. Yeah, yes. Yes, after all this time.
Yeah.
It's now been proven. Now, listen, the question is this. You're a television star. You're a pretty big deal. You put on makeup and sat next to Karen Borda. You know? I mean, you got a pretty good life going. Why do you want to chuck all of that to come over here?
Simple answer. I've got to go. I've got a kid who's going into high school. He's going to be playing ball, and I want to see him play those games.
You can do that from over at Channel 11, can't you?
Yeah, but you might get there late. And we're expecting a little girl, and I'd like to be there at night to kiss her goodnight.
Oh, now that's interesting.
But, you know, it's fun because everybody's always asked me, which is better, television or radio? And I said, well, anybody can tell a story with pictures.
Yes.
To do it without pictures, just the language.
Yep.
And create emotion. You know, the sound, the sense of hearing is one of the first sensations that we develop as human beings. And so the music and the words that we use and the attitude that we take on the radio, it develops into so many different ways that we approach our days. And so that's the exciting part.
And you have come from a long...
Oh, Jesus.
God, quit. All right.
Here we go.
We'll continue as we tell pictures, as we tell stories without pictures.
It'd be a lot funnier if I'd have gotten it out.
Develop as human beings. And so the music and the words that we use and the attitude that we take on the radio, it develops into so many different ways that we approach our days. And so that's the exciting part.
And you have come from a long line of telling verbal stories.
Let me
try to give you some idea of how long it has been. This is Lake City Radio, and what's the call letters?
KPAR.
KPAR in Granbury, Texas. Is this your first job?
It was my first in this area.
All right.
Listen. Is this an air check?
Yeah, he's playing his air check.
Ah, okay.
KPAR.
pay off.
1420 reminding you that the Faith Baptist Church of Hill City invites you and your family to worship with them this next Sunday. Sunday school starts at 10 a.m., preaching at 11, and the evening worship is at 6. And tonight, midweek services will be held at 7 p.m. KPAR gets involved. If you've ever had trouble with interior pipe corrosion or mineral buildup, and it's cutting down on the life of your plumbing, you know how expensive... I've
already got a critique, okay?
Yeah. It's begun.
You know, I once told Jocelyn White worked with us for years.
Oh, sure,
right?
Yeah.
And one day after she'd been working for several weeks, Jocelyn caught me in the corridor and...
Does it get any better?
It just kind of rattles from here on out.
Is there any more ass-kissing going on?
Toward the end, where and he goes into a typical Chapman hook, you know, where we want to say...
All right, I got it.
I don't know.
How much longer?
I don't know how long the whole thing is. You have to ask Rob.
Rob, what's the total time on this?
It's about 4:30, I think.
Okay, it's almost over.
All right.
Said, give me your critique right now. And I said two words to her. I said, don't gush. Okay? That was it. I said, don't gush, you know, because she tended to be so sweet and so nice on the air. I said, don't gush. So what I'm saying to you after listening to that, don't gasp.
Don't gasp. I'll try. Listen, I do have to say something in all seriousness. Okay. You have been my best friend for, gosh, how long have we known each other? 1981?
Yeah, somewhere in there.
Yeah, yeah, and you've given me the best advice, and I didn't always listen to it, as you well know. But it is an honor. It's a privilege. It's a blessing. And I said this to many people, the greatest thing about this is knowing that there is nothing I could ever do to earn or deserve this.
Well, I think you're about to start doing that right now.
Ladies and gentlemen, Jody Dean takes over. He walks in when I walk out and...
Welcome back.
That all of it?
That's it.
Okay.
I'll keep this over here.
All right. All right, then.
All right.
It's another big moment.
Mm-hmm.
Bookmark. A milestone in radio broadcasting.
Yes.
Do we have time for news?
Yes.
Okay.
Oh. Let's see what Dan's got lined up here.
Two. Yeah, Kevin?
Hey, I'm driving down 635. There's a car next to me. You can tell the guy's listening to you. You start making that throw-up sound, he has to pull over and dry heave on the side of the freeway.
We'll be back to the
Russ. Penn State University found that a shocking amount of American girls as young as 9 years old are using anabolic steroids. About 5% of high school girls and 7% of middle school girls admit to trying steroids at least once. In the overwhelmingly majority of the cases, girls are doing this basically to try to get better, not to get better at sports, but just to lose weight and get toned and look better, more like models and movie stars. Mm-hmm. The potential side effects are terrible, though. Severe acne, smaller breasts, deeper voice, irregular menstruation, excessive facial and body hair, depression, paranoia, and eventually heart attacks, strokes, and some forms of cancer. Practice made perfect for the North Texas.
Get all that from anabolic steroids?
Yeah. Eventually.
Is that just with women or guys, too?
No, those are standard side effects. Well, obviously, with the exception of the smaller breasts. Those are all general side effects for any male or female on anabolic steroids. But
I don't know why you'd run the risk.
No, I have no idea.
I mean, so far, I haven't seen anything since I've been working out for a couple of years. Uh-huh. And obviously, you see people on roids. I don't get the risk or the risk factor. Uh-huh. Why you want to... All right, so you got big muscles. And you're huge.
Right.
It's not going to last. It's not real. You're starting to look like a caveman because your head's growing. Your forehead's going this way, and your jaw gets really jutty.
Right.
And then you run the risk of, what is this stuff?
All the stuff. Well, all the side effects are severe acne, smaller breasts in women, deeper voice, irregular menstruation, excessive facial hair and body hair, depression, paranoia, eventually heart attacks, strokes, and some forms of cancer.
Yeah, the stuff on the tail end of that.
Yeah, the stuff that'll kill you. It you know what it basically boils down to? It's for people that have never matured past that teenage stance of I'm invincible. In other words, sure, I know the statistics, but it's not going to happen.
Here's where the difference is with steroids. You can go it two ways, like drinking. Okay, you don't see immediate changes. That's going to be a long time down the road. With steroids, you see changes immediately, and your head starts jutting out, and you get the jaw thing. Mm-hmm. Just the fact that you start to look like a caveman would be enough for me to stop. Because when you stop on the steroids, your body goes back to normal or flab, That caveman stuff doesn't, it doesn't revert back. You're stuck like that.
And a lot of people will think, and I've known, not women, but I've known men that have said this, I'll just do one cycle. I'll just do it one time so I get just that little exercise I want, and I won't end up like a, you know, like a complete caveman look.
Right.
Might see some subtle changes if I do, say, 1 8- or 10-week cycle, but I'll do it just the one time. The problem is, they think just that one time, well, I was pretty happy with it, and I felt really good. I'll do one more. The next thing you know...
And then that'll be it. It's just like, it's justifying anything. Rationalization.
Right. Yeah, it's, and then it's a domino effect from there.
Well, what is Rob on?
He's not, 'cause
he don't look like a caveman.
No. Well, he's not on anabolic steroids, though.
What's he on?
He's on the testosterone.
Is that it?
Right now, I think so.
Is that all you've been on, Rob, is test?
Yeah, and some Loraballin.
On for what?
It's called Loraballin. It's almost like a Deca.
Is that now or in the past?
I'm doing some now.
Is this illegal?
Not for animals.
His dog's gonna look great.
My God.
The dynamics of this show, it's just amazing how it continues to evolve and be frightening.
Yeah. And I'm surprised the DEA hasn't busted us yet, or the ATF.
Yeah, the fire department or police department.
Then we have it in our back pocket.
Or the health department. Okay. Oh, I forgot. Are you going to go with him? Make sure this comes up during the session tomorrow if you're going to go.
Okay.
Now, this is not a bit. You really got to go because he's really going.
Okay, I'll go. If you think maybe the first session he ought to be by himself, or should we go ahead and start together?
Rob, can you see if Dr. Robbins is available?
Okay.
Normally, she's got time like 10 minutes to the hour.
Yeah.
Because that's when her session's in. So it may not be even until almost 6. That would be her call. She's the pro on this. Okay. If you guys should go together or just do Rob for a while. And
well, Rob and I don't really have a problem together other than what happened last week. But that's over.
But you guys weren't talking to each other.
Just for 2 days.
And it's never happened again. Never happened before.
No. Everything's cheering, happy in the office.
Obviously, there's more to it because he wants you to go.
I think he just don't want to go alone. Figured he'd drag me too.
I don't understand what he thinks is going to happen.
He don't want to go.
First of all, you're going to stand there and stare at some hot chick for almost an hour.
Yeah.
Tell her whatever she wants to know. She's not going to make any judgment calls. Then when she gets up to go to the bathroom, you get a nice sniff of her chair, and then you go home.
I'll pass on the last part.
The way my sessions always ended.
I'm quite sure they did.
That's a hot woman.
Mm-hmm.
I may have to start going again. I miss that chair.
God.
It's our favorite chair. It's
nasty.
Too. That's not nasty.
It is.
Because that's as close as I'm going to get. Okay, go ahead.
Okie dokie. A tracking firm, Rasmussen, reports that Americans, quote, ask them, do you believe that every word in the Bible is literally true and is the word of God? The result? How many people do you think believe that every word is literally true and is the word of God, percentage-wise of Americans?
Are these people in general or Christians?
These are people in general.
Oh. Let me think. Does it say who they talk to?
It does not.
All right. Half.
You're pretty close. 63% of Americans say yes, they believe every single word in the Bible is true. Only 24% said no, or it's not, and 13% were undecided. By race, 82% of blacks believe that the Bible is literally true, versus 59% of whites and 71% of Hispanics. Well, practice made perfect for a North Texas teen who topped her flawless 1600 score on the old SAT with a new 2400 score, another perfect on the new version. Erin Yu is her name. She's 17. Among 7 Texans and 107 students nationwide earn a perfect 800 on each of the 3 sections, writing, critical reading, and math. We should take a SAT at some point and see where we are. We're probably embarrassing. I can't remember what I made.
What is average on an SAT, Dan?
Well, the old one, perfect, was 1600.
You mean, like, national average?
I don't care. I never took one. I went straight from junior college to North Texas for that 3 months.
If I had to guess a general average, I would say probably around 1,000. Because I would say that that's fairly safe. Now, that's based on the old score on 1,600.
Has it changed?
Yeah, just the new...
It went up.
The new test is now 2,400 is perfect.
Because they added in an essay portion onto the test.
How long does an SAT take?
Well, it depends if you take it hungover or not. usually about 3 hours.
3 to 4 hours.
Oh, that's not bad. Yeah. Well, we could do it in shifts. Or, I mean, you know, like,
yeah, there's three
if you did
sections.
It on Saturday, go for an hour, come back another Saturday. Because I'm not going to sit there for 3-4 hours at once. Yeah. Obviously, that's not going to give you a fair representation because part of the SAT is sitting there for 4 hours and figuring this crap out.
Yeah.
I think I got 1150 or something, maybe 1200.
Mine would probably be, what all do you have to know?
Three sections, writing, critical reading, and math.
No.
The good thing is, with the writing section, they did away with, well, good if you like this. Since they put in the writing section, they took away analogies. So if you stunk at analogies, at least you got that out of the way.
I bet it score 5.
No, you
5?
No.
I'll bet 5 to 600.
Nah. Out of 2,400?
Yeah.
No, you wouldn't.
Well, you also have to keep in mind, had you taken it back in high school, all that stuff was fresh in your mind. You were preparing for it. I mean, if you were actually going to take it now, would you prepare for it or just go in cold and just see what happens?
I think probably taking an IQ test would be a better barometer right now.
Yeah,
yeah, because
you don't really study for those. You go in and take it, right?
Yeah, and the thing is with an SAT test, that doesn't necessarily tell anyone how smart you are. In a lot of cases, that shows how good you are at taking a test and preparing for a test. It's not going to really gauge your overall intelligence.
Yeah. How long's an IQ test take?
I have no idea. Never taken one.
Actually, I think it just depends on which test you take. There's so many different kinds. I think there are some that take 15, 20 minutes. But most of those are on the internet, and I don't know if we trust those.
Mm. This girl's a junior at Plano Senior High School, and she came from northern China.
Why are we talking about her?
Because she scored a perfect... She's only one...
2,400?
Yeah, 2,400. It's pretty impressive.
She was from Asia?
Came from northern China to the U.S. when she was 3.
Oh. Okay, so it's all written on the SAT.
Mm-hmm.
Obviously, no driving.
Euless police say one woman is dead, another one injured after a shooting in a bowling alley in Euless. One woman was shot in the shoulder and was taken to an area hospital. The other one, 21-year-old Yi Nguyen, was fatally shot in the head. Investigators at the Showplace Lanes bowling alley say a fight led to the violence, actually. Police say Nguyen was arguing with another woman when a gunman shot her. Witnesses then told police he fled the scene. They're still looking for him. It's right by my house. I used to go take the kids there all the time.
Mm.
Male-female equality has come a long way just in the past 20 years, but research by the Welsh firm of YouGov finds that one old-fashioned gender role is still in place. It finds women spend approximately 10% of their lives in the kitchen. In 8 out of 10 households, women still do most of the cooking. 1 in 10 men say they never cook. Overall, women spend 8 hours each week in the kitchen.
I don't think I've seen Amy cook once.
Have you ever asked her, does she cook?
I don't know if she does or not. Just any time that she comes over, I cook.
Well, you're the chef.
Well, not necessarily. I've...
You're good at it and you enjoy it. It's like Joy can cook, she just doesn't.
Is that what you do?
I cook. She makes a couple dishes and I cook. We go out mostly.
Oh.
I don't have a big kitchen like you do.
What about you and Gretchen?
I'd say, I guess, kind of even, but like on some nights she'll have something, but it's not like she's making dishes. It's usually something that's made in 15, 20 minutes.
Mm.
It's nothing really elaborate.
What does she wear around the apartment?
It just depends. I'm a big fan of like a tank top and PJ pants, so that happens quite often.
With her boobs sticking out the side?
Not quite out the side. They're perkier than that.
Well, I mean, just from the width.
Oh, yeah, a little bit if the shirt's tight enough.
Mm.
Okay. Do you care about Michael Jackson anymore?
Hang on.
Okay.
All right, go ahead.
Okay. Judge Rodney Melville made it official yesterday, ruling that Michael Jackson's second ex-wife, Debbie Rowe...
All right, stop again. Who is it, Dan?
It's Dr. Scott. He has something for you about IQ tests.
Dr. Thornton?
Yes.
Okay. Hi, Scotty.
Hey, Russ. How you doing?
Good.
Good. IQ tests, the real one, the Wechsler Adult Intelligence Scale, take about an hour and a half.
Well, that's not bad.
Yeah. Maybe even shorter, depending on, you know, how good the examiner is.
What? Where do you go to get take these?
I can give you the name of somebody. I don't do them anymore. It's been a long time, but I can give you the name of somebody that can hook you up, I'm sure. And as far as those internet tests goes, go, I don't think that that's going to give you as nearly as accurate a read as the full-blown Wechsler. It measures all kinds of different areas.
What all do they cover?
Verbal, vocabulary, similarities is a test of your abstract reasoning abilities, mathematical reasoning ability, eye-hand coordination, interpersonal awareness, motor speed, all kinds of things. And all those correlate pretty highly with verbal IQ. So when you take something like the SAT or something like that, your score will have a pretty high correlation with your intelligence. Like I think it was Chloe was saying, though, those tests really do measure more your achievement than your IQ, but it's still pretty highly correlated with your IQ.
You say that, Chloe?
Sure.
So, just wanted to tell you about that. You want me to give you a number of somebody?
I don't think so. I feel stupid enough just you running through the categories. Because I'm listening for one that I could do well in.
All right.
Run them down again.
You do very well in vocabulary, I'm sure.
Actually, my vocabulary is limited.
You'd be surprised, but okay. I'm a trained mental health professional, and I can tell. But anyway, you do very well in similarities.
I spend most of my time trying to cover up how stupid I am.
That's smart. That's a verbal skill.
It would have been a lot smarter just to
learn the words. Huh?
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. You always put yourself down IQ wise.
No. I'm being realistic.
Yeah.
Because there are a lot of things I just can't grasp. I got the basics on stuff. I can function.
Yeah.
In society, I can't, since this show's more of a freak show, that's why it's a success. Mm-hmm. It's not because I'm smart or I've got insight onto to life and how to live it. It's just because it's a comfortable show.
Well, it really is your personality, and so, yeah, you're really in a groove with that. But didn't you say once that you had a kind of an ADD thing?
Yeah.
Yeah. That's what's gotten in your way. It's not
that reminds me.
A publicist for George Lopez said yesterday, George underwent a kidney transplant last week, and the donor was his own wife, Ann Lopez. George and Ann, by the way, resting comfortably in their L.A. home and are both expected to make a full recovery.
That's weird that they would both match to where she could give him a kidney.
Very strange. Very odd. Lopez has an undisclosed genetic condition that caused his kidney deterioration. George and Ann have been married 12 years, and they have a daughter.
Did you say that 2020? What's that show that sucks that you keep watching?
A Current Affair.
Yeah, they had the black chick and her kid on again?
They had, last night they spent, they got doctors in there, they had lawyers in there.
I finally saw the video.
Yeah.
I don't know if we talked about this yesterday or not.
We did at the end of the show.
Okay. I saw it. And at first I'm going, well, all right, it's overreaction. But that kid, all right. What's going to be the downside of that kid being handcuffed? Any emotional scarring forever?
No.
No. She's going to know if you act up, something's going to happen.
Right.
What's wrong with that?
I don't see anything at all.
She wasn't hit, and they did it to help the kid.
Yeah, she was out of control. Now, of course, they show in the video when she's sitting there quietly when the police walk up to her. Yeah, when the cops finally got there, she settled down because she knew she was really in trouble.
And where did this kid learn to hit?
I don't know.
Obviously, that all came from the house.
Right.
She didn't learn that in daycare. No. She didn't learn that, you know, sitting there watching other people.
No, and they've had trouble with this kid before. They get, somebody get angry, but when the cops walk up, they go, you remember me? Okay, and here's the handcuffs we talked about. So the police have been calling this child previously.
Oh, I didn't know that.
Yes. Somebody's going, oh, so you're threatening the child. No, I'm saying, welcome back. I've had to come out here before.
Yeah, why am I here again?
Yeah. Why is a police officer called to a school again for a five-year-old? Once is ridiculous. And they'll get cash
because they don't want to watch their kids.
No.
And they want somebody else to take care of them.
That's exactly what she said on television Friday night when she was on The Current Affair. Who is the guy that hosts that? He is the worst.
Anyway. I don't know, but that's the show that didn't send me no donuts.
That was weird.
What, Dan?
His name's Tim Green. He's a I looked at his bio somewhere. He's an author. He's an attorney and a former NFL football player.
All right. I haven't seen it yet.
But the one thing he is not is a TV host.
A host.
Is it that bad? Have you seen it?
I've seen one episode. It was the episode right after they were covering
the football coach that was shot out in Canton. And he's horrible. He's a horrible interviewer. He's got that throaty football player voice going on.
Well, it makes you want to go back and think who they turned down for the job.
Absolutely.
Exactly.
He's just overreaction. He's overdramatic. And he's making a ridiculous statement. And they did it again Friday and again last night. They're talking when he talked to a police officer. And somebody who looks at situations from outside looking into police departments.
Right.
And the guy goes, I'm not going to second guess what a police officer does because that's ridiculous. He goes, they did what was done right correctly and no one got hurt.
Well, you got a bunch of other things you got to consider. Yeah. You got policy. What do we do with this kid? What happens if I restrain this kid with my hands and I squeeze too hard?
Exactly.
I got to worry about being sued. I got to worry about controlling some kid that's not controllable at home. So why is it they think I can do a good job here? They put handcuffs on her and they set her in the corner and you sit there until you gel out and have mom come get you.
Mm-hmm. Well, they put her in the police car.
Oh, did they?
Yeah. They took her out and put her in the cop car. They got her out of the area, out of the school.
And then what happened?
And they also actually did the plastic cuffs around her feet and then put her in the car.
But I'm going, who are you going to sue? Or why are you going to sue?
Excessive force.
That wasn't excessive force. Slapping the kid around like she needed to be done, that's excessive force.
I totally agree with you.
And I don't mean, in an abusive situation. It's just a whack on the ass. Go, hey, knock that crap off.
Can't do that.
And every time you act up, you're going to get a swat. So at least you get a reactionary thing.
You know she's never been disciplined at home. You wouldn't act like that. You wouldn't come at a teacher and a principal with your arms doing the roundhouse, doing the windmill thing, and climb the wall and tear things up and throw them around.
You want to hear this 911 call I found?
Sure.
It's not very entertaining, but I enjoyed finding it.
Okay.
That makes sense?
Yeah. Yeah.
Police emergency 911. What is your emergency?
I'm having a situation with my child. You see, she's 9 years old, and she won't do anything that I tell her to do. And she's broken a lamp and some of my pictures. And what'd she say after you whooped her ass? I don't beat my child.
So what you want me to do?
I want you to send an officer over here to make her mind.
You want me to send a highly trained police officer over to your home to control a child that you can't?
Yes, that's your job. I want an officer over here right now. Hey, you going to send one? You're denying my request? Well, what is your name?
You going to send me a gift?
I want to know what your name is.
Quit it. You good? Quite topical. After the one thing that happened here.
What?
That mom that called the cops on her daughters that were fighting.
Oh.
That happened here, and then we had this deal with the school.
Yeah.
The cops got to get involved again to raise children.
I've been sitting on this. I forgot I had it.
Oh.
I listened to it. I went, you know what? That's not that funny. But now it's just a little, it's kind of topical.
Yeah.
I don't mind them being on top of stuff for a change.
Mm-hmm.
Back it up. How come this ain't backing up?
You can't. Yes, that's your job. I want an officer over here right now.
Mm-hmm.
Are you going to send one?
Mm-hmm.
You're denying my request?
Mm-hmm.
Well, what is your name?
You going to send me a gift?
I want to know what your name is.
It's Propecia Niqua.
It's what?
Propecia Niqua. Propecia Niqua.
Spell it.
All right. Now, what else you want?
I want you to send the police over here right now.
I got it.
I tell you what I will do. I come over there. I'll whoop that little rude bitch's ass of yours. I'll whoop your f***ing ass. And then we're going to hold a f***ing seminar on why the police ain't here to raise your damn whiny f***ing out of control spoiled loudmouth kids. Why don't you start with some discipline? Why don't you get a belt? I bet they'd like a nice roundhouse in the puss. This time out, boy, just gives them time to think of how to f*** with you. Mother f***, what the f*** is wrong with you people? You want me to explain to someone being raped that we can't make it out because your dumb f*** kid won't stop playing their ColecoVision? You go f*** yourself, you f*** ass bag, saggy f***, ass flappy f***, having out of touch reality soccer mom f***. Don't you ever call here again.
Very nice. Propecia Niqua got a job.
We'll be back to the Russ Martin Show. Now, to the Russ Martin Show.
Yes, Dan?
Rob found you a lap band, Doctor. This is Dr. Ortiz.
Thank you. Good afternoon, Dr. Ortiz.
Good afternoon, Russ. How you doing?
I'm fine. How exactly does the lap band procedure work?
Very beautifully. Getting down to business. There's a number of surgeries that are now being used for weight loss. The unique way of performing the surgery is putting a band around the stomach, which actually puts a squeeze on the stomach and diminishes the patient's ability to eat. Very straightforward, very basic. Now, that idea has been there around for many years, and 11 and a half years ago, a surgeon from Belgium said, well, why don't we do this and we make it adjustable?
Yeah.
Placing a band around the stomach and then placing a port under the skin, under the belly fat, a small little quarter-sized air receptacle where after the surgery, you can, with a small little needle prick, inflate, and that's connected to a tube that goes up around the stomach and actually closes the band or adjusts the band, catering to the patient's need.
That's perfect. So I'll have that one.
they designed that 11 and a half years ago.
I don't understand why anybody would either have do the stomach staple or have part of their stomach removed when you can do this band thingy.
Well, we totally agree. Now, we've been saying that for many years, and fortunately for our popularity, a year and a half ago, a beautiful study, a scientific study came out actually proving two things. The lap band, or the band around the stomach,
yes,
is the safest option in the world. It's every single study proved it, 10 times safer than the gastric stapling, the gastric bypass.
I think I'm going to get this. John, you want one?
No. How much overweight you got to be to get this, doctor?
Well, why don't we keep on talking a little bit before I actually give you the punchline?
Now, what is the punchline? Because I don't like these shows. How overweight do you need to be?
Well, the most important thing is that obesity varies in degrees. Now, we scientifically have classified it between obesity, morbid obesity, the one that actually does kill you, and super obese and super, super obese. Now, if I'm talking in pounds, these patients are varying from 200 pounds all the way to 600, 800, 1,000 pounds or even more.
That's 200 pounds overweight or 200 pounds?
Some of my patients are actually 200 pounds. Now,
well, what's the least amount of weight I can be overweight and get the lap band?
I'm going to ask you exactly what I ask any other of my patients. What's your height and what's your weight?
I'm 6 foot even and about 185 pounds.
185 pounds. You should be at around 23 body mass index, which makes you ideal weight. An ideal weight.
So you're not going to give me the lap band?
No. Something that's not popular. Unfortunately, you do not qualify, but anybody over 50 pounds or heavier may qualify for the surgery, especially if there's other diseases related to the...
What did you hang up on him for?
Yeah, it might have changed his analysis if you stuck out your stomach and
other
made the
face.
Other
people might have some use for it.
This was for me.
I know.
I want the lap band.
You're not getting the lap band.
I'm going to get my stomach stapled.
Oh, dear Jesus. No doctor on the planet will do that for you. None. What did he say? Let me think. Ideal weight.
I think my BMI is 21.
You're ideal.
Why do I feel fat?
Because JD made the mistake of saying that you have a roll.
He's felt that before, and I didn't do anything.
You said it. He's been on a tear ever since.
He listens to me. When?
When you say he's got rolls.
Don't put him back there. He ain't giving me the lap band. Unless he's got a punchline like he said he did. Does he have one? Ask him.
Hey, let me get to the punchline.
Because that stomach staple humor can be pretty funny.
Yeah.
Stitch.
It's a good idea.
Mm-hmm. Doesn't he sound like that guy?
And very much.
I'll just get liposuction.
Don't need liposuction. There's nothing to suck.
Yeah, there's plenty.
You know what? I don't know why I've had this feeling, and it's happened ever since I started working out. It ain't muscle. So knock it off.
It's not fat. You've been measured. You're low teens.
I feel fat.
You couldn't possibly be fat. If someone came to you and said, hey, I know this guy. He works out 22 times a month and eats whatever it is you eat.
Low fat.
Yeah.
You want to go over to the Cooper Clinic and do the water immersion thing and get the exact percentage of fat your body is? And if you're 13, 14%, you'll shut up?
What does that cost?
I'm sure we could swing it for you.
How long you got to sit in the water?
I don't know. I pucker. It's not hours. Probably 10 minutes. I don't know. I can find
What did he say? Did he have a funny punchline?
It took him 5 minutes and I hung up on him.
God.
He never got to it.
Yeah.
If I'm bored with it, I know as sure as hell you're going to be.
I understand.
Save us both the grief. Here he calls again.
Did he have a website or anything we could plug for him? Tell him that.
I'll check with him.
All right. Tell him I'm in the middle of an interview with someone else.
Yeah.
Where were we?
Cooper Clinic.
Yeah.
The water submerged.
How long I got to sit in there?
I don't know. Ten minutes.
I pucker.
I know you pucker, but we'll get you in 10 minutes. I'll call up there next.
Do you sit in there in like a harness?
I do not know. You know,
how do you know about this?
I've read about the process, and I know the Cooper Clinic's one, in fact, probably the only place locally that does it. And Todd Whitthorne, who I did Good Morning Texas with, now works at the Cooper Clinic. So I'll call him, and I'll get you in.
When did you work with him?
When he was on Channel 8, he hosted Good Morning Texas for a number of years. Todd Whitthorne.
When did you work with him?
I just co-hosted 1 week when I was at KSES.
Did I know this?
96, yeah. It was 96.
I don't think I saw it, though.
I've told you before.
Oh. Okay. It only takes 10 minutes?
I'll find out the specifics for you. And we'll get you in. If you really want to do that.
Yeah.
Okay.
That way I can stop obsessing about this. Because every day I stand in the mirror.
I know.
And have to get close to the mirror, back up. Turn different lights on and off until I get the exact look that I want. Then I'm okay.
Do you really do that?
Every day.
In the morning when you get up?
Yeah, it doesn't matter. I don't even like looking in mirrors.
Do you do it several?
And you look better than you've ever looked in your entire life.
I won't look at mirrors in I don't like my picture being taken. I won't look in the mirrors when I'm working out in the gym. The only reason I look in the mirror is to shave.
Jesus.
That's a shame.
Well, it is considering the body you have now. You've got to admit you're in better shape than you've ever been.
For me, I'm stronger.
Than you've ever been?
Yes.
Okay. And your body fat, well, it's like you've always had low body fat since the 80s.
Is this something to be concerned about, Everett?
Well, I mean, I don't know that going to the Cooper Clinic is necessarily the right remedy.
What should I do?
Well,
lap band?
No.
Stomach.
No, I think it all starts in your head.
It's like chicks that are anorexic still see themselves as fat.
Yeah, it's distorted body image. You can actually have them draw on a chalkboard an outline of their body, and it's far horribly disproportionately larger than what they actually
look
like.
Give me a pen.
This is what you see in the mirror.
Yes.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. I can do this to be cute, but that won't get me too far.
Okay.
My legs are normal.
You need help.
Why?
It's not even close to what your body looks like.
It's what it looks like to me.
Well, it's sad. You need help then, because that's not what it looks like.
This is where my belly button is.
I understand.
And these are my legs.
You have normal legs.
And that's that.
You have an extremely distorted image of your genitals.
All right.
That I have seen many times.
Dan, is that him on the hotline again? Tell him we're doing fire drill. Hang up on him again?
Yeah, I told him we're having phone issues all day and apologize for any inconvenience.
Oh, very nice. What did he say?
I don't know. I hung up on him.
Oh, I got it.
No, he was just giving me his website stuff. If you want me to say it now.
Yeah, right. Give it out.
Obesitycontrolcenter.com, and for his book, it's lap-bandforlife.com.
All right. And what's the web again?
Obesitycontrolcenter.com.
Okay. All right. Good. All right. All right, you can do news now.
Okie dokie. 40-year-old Rhonda Nichols of Centerville, Missouri, has filed a lawsuit Wednesday this week against Lowe's Home Center, rather, in Alton, Missouri. She wants $50,000. The reason? She claims she was shopping at the Lowe's Outdoor Garden Center and a bird flew into her. She claims the bird, which is about the size of a robin, caused the injuries to her head,
I'm not very happy,
brain, neck, muscles, bones, nerves, discs, and ligaments, and also led to her losing some neurological function and cognitive skills. Because she can't say what day it specifically happened. She's probably out of luck. She says it was on or about April 15th, 2003. Lowe says it has no record of any human-bird collisions on that day.
How much money does she want?
$50,000. Mm. Has a bird hit you?
No.
No. We've all taken a dog into a bite into a dog treat, rather, at some point, just to see what it tastes like. Now there's a bakery out of Kansas City, Missouri, that you actually can eat your dog's treats. Three Dog Bakery is selling a new Lick and Crunch sandwich cookie treat, which actually looks like an Oreo, they say. And dogs and humans will like it each. They, instead of putting chocolate in it, they put carob in it, which dogs apparently
can. Are you out of news stories?
No, I get plenty more.
You're reading about dog treats.
I thought you would think that's funny because you got a dog and you ate the treat one time. You put it in your mouth and it was nasty.
Yeah.
Well,
that's funny to get drunk and eat dog treats and you're shocked that it tastes like piss.
Tell us more about carob.
Yeah.
I was going to ask you guys, why does chocolate make dogs sick?
It's just something that when they process it in their system, I think they can have it in small amounts, but since you don't know what that amount is, right, you don't give them anything.
Gotcha. Well, these are $6 for a box of 36.
Is that right, Everett?
That's what I'm. Understand.
Yeah, you never give them chocolate.
Okay. 31-year-old Michael Scallon of Whitney Point, New
Dan,
York.
Dan, was that him on the hotline again?
Yeah, he was trying to say he's got like patient meetings for anyone that has questions about lap bands.
So he's not done being on the show?
No.
All right. We've given out his website. I'm sure all the information's on there.
It is. I've checked.
All right. I was just being cute about having a lap band doctor. I didn't realize he was going to be a tick.
I think he's from Mexico.
Really?
Yeah.
That's a hotline again. See if that's him. Leave your mic on.
Oh, man. Hello? Oh, Gail says it's because of the caffeine in the chocolate.
Oh.
So it's not Dr. Ortiz.
Oh, all right. Thank her.
Thank you, Gail.
Go ahead, John.
If you're wondering about what you should be wearing this spring and summer, with the folks at the Dallas Morning News fashion section say, guys, the new summer color is pink. Get casual with a pink polo shirt.
Yeah, the new stories, aren't you?
No, I thought that was...
Read
the
carol.
I'll just read. I'm going to read the headlines. You tell me yes or no.
All right. How are we doing, Chloe? All right, go ahead.
All 91 German Walmart stores now host a singles night every Friday night. Pack them in.
Is that your new pronunciation for
Walmart?
No, stores, if you're talking about them in German.
Yeah, German. Yes, true stores.
Yeah.
What's the matter with you? 78% of people are okay with openly gay athletes.
No.
All righty. A-Rod saves a boy from getting hit by a truck.
It's mildly curious. Yes, what did the A-Rod do?
Alex Rodriguez saved an 8-year-old boy from serious injury when he prevented the youngster from getting hit by a truck. He was standing in a crosswalk on Newbury Street near downtown Boston about 3:30 on Tuesday when he saw the boy start to run across the street directly in the path of an oncoming truck. Rodriguez reached out and grabbed the boy, pulling him back and preventing serious injury. Rodriguez said he also had to hurry to avoid being hit by the truck. I almost got it too, he said.
Had it not been for my steroids, I'd not make it. Is that the right accent for him?
Not even close.
Who am I thinking of?
I don't know.
You're pretty much every other Rodriguez in the Major League Baseball. But
is there a Juan? Juan Gonzalez.
There's Juan Gonzalez. That would be a good one for Juan Gonzalez.
All right.
Okay. Or
what does A-Rod sound like?
Like you and I? He actually, he's from, like, Florida. He's obviously of Hispanic descent, but he's, if you heard him on the phone or on the radio, he sounds like a white guy.
Oh, all right. Then I apologize.
We'll
to
move
the,
on. A-Rod. Where's the mini disc from earlier that had the name?
I don't know. You don't mark anything.
It's the one that didn't have any markings on it.
All
right. some Boston Reds, this would be cut number two. Some Boston Red Sox fan actually took a swing at a New York Yankee, the right fielder Gary Sheffield, as he was fielding a ball along the outfield wall in Boston's Fenway Park last night. Sheffield shoved the fan once, then turned around, threw the ball back in, then swung around at the fan with his fist cocked back, but he did restrain himself. Here's his comments after the game cut two.
Well, I don't know if he punched me. It felt like it. You know, I thought my lip was busted, and I was trying to continue with the play, and then I thought about, you know, he hit me, and then I thought about, don't react.
Was this an ugly situation that could have been even worse?
Well, yeah, I didn't hit him.
My composure, you know, I almost snapped, but the thing is that I thought about the consequences.
Gary, it looks after the first time you guys collided, you did start to go back the second time. Did you pull yourself back out of it? Did you actually take a swipe at him? What happened?
No, I didn't throw no punch or nothing. I just, you know, my temper got the best of me.
Didn't he already explain this?
Yes.
I was going to hit him and I didn't.
Right.
You know, after the fact, you know, when I realized what happened.
What did you tell Joe?
I just tried to point the guy out. You know, they was trying to, you know, tell me to calm down and just point the guy out and they'll take action from there.
The Boston Herald says that Bobby Brown has failed to show up, by the way, in a Massachusetts court this week to explain why he's not paying his child support to the mother of his two teenage kids. Bobby's ex-girlfriend, Kim Ward, says he owes between 3 and 4 months support. That's about 15 grand. Last year, by the way, Bobby spent a day in prison for non-payment before coming up with a $63,500 to settle the tab. That case has now been delayed till later in the month. Well, some folks are flipping out over a comment that Brendan Fraser made in the current issue of Elle magazine. When asked for some advice he might someday give to his two young sons about women, he said, "Listen to women, and please put a little pinhole in the condom, because we want to be grandparents sooner rather than later." Ron Prentice from the California Family Council has called Brendan Fraser's comments incredibly irresponsible. It's unfortunate that Mr. Fraser's comments, that are understood to be in jest, refer to such a serious subject.
He just understood. He said he understood he was kidding.
Yes.
So why is he saying anything?
I don't know.
Is that right?
Yeah, it's bizarre.
It's understood he said it in jest.
Yes.
Which means it don't count.
But it refers to a very serious subject.
But he said he knows it was in jest.
I know.
Hold on. Hi, Amy.
Hi. So you want to get the lap band surgery done, huh?
Yes. How much is it?
My insurance actually paid for mine, but it was total almost $30,000.
Well, what did you have out of pocket?
Out of pocket, maybe $1,000,
$1,500. That ain't bad.
No, it wasn't bad, and it was really very easy. It didn't hurt.
How much did you weigh?
I'm not going to tell you how much I weigh, but I had a body mass index of 35, and now it's cut in half, more than in half.
How much did you weigh?
No, I know that you're crappy when it comes to women and their weight, so we're not going to go there.
I'm not saying anything. I just want to know how much of an improvement you made.
I weighed about 230, and now I weigh about 150.
All right. It's not bad. You still losing weight?
No, actually, nobody wants me to lose anymore. My husband doesn't want me to.
How tall are you?
I'm about 5'10", 5'11".
Yeah, you can carry 150.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's...
You got any of that nasty skin hanging?
No, not really, actually. I was lucky when it comes to that. I got really lucky.
Because there are a lot of people, it's almost like you don't want to lose the weight, because afterwards, after you lose it naked, you look like a piece of KFC.
And I was worried about that, actually. I was kind of fearing about that, but they won't actually even talk to you about the plastic surgery until it's been at least a year to 2 years, because they want to actually see what happens with that.
Okay.
It was the easiest surgery I ever had in my life. I was up right. We've got horses, and I was riding them within a week and a half again.
Are you laughing at her?
Seeing a punchline go by in my head.
Thank you. So you recommend this for me then?
No.
Oh, Russ, it was the greatest thing. You can still mess it up if you sit around drinking milkshakes all day, because stuff will still go through it.
Okay.
He's not fat. He's not fat. He doesn't need this.
But stuff like, I don't know, junk food and real bready kind of things and pasta, doughy kind of things,
yeah,
it just comes right back up. You just can't do it.
You yak it?
Well, it's hard to explain. It's not like throwing up like when you have food poisoning. It just comes back up. It's not...
That's vomiting.
Kind of, but not with such force. It just won't stay there.
Kind of crawls back out?
Kind of, yeah. Ambles. Honestly. That's kind of how it feels, actually.
Okay. That's got to be very odd.
Yeah.
It's really, the weirdest thing about it, Russ, is when you have the band tightened up for the first time.
So it's almost like it forces it back out just by pressure, but not out of a muscle reaction, right, like when you vomit.
Exactly.
Yeah. I think I'd rather vomit.
Mm.
It doesn't, no, ooh, no, that's awful. But that doesn't hurt, it doesn't bother me anymore. But
you convinced me I'm getting it.
The creepiest thing, Russ, is when you have the lap band tightened.
Mm-hmm.
The one that I have, it carries 4 cc's of saline, and I've got 2.5 in mine right now.
Right.
And when they tighten it up, it almost feels like there's a finger or a hand wrapping around your stomach on the inside. It feels really creepy, because it's not a sensation that you're really supposed
you're
to ever
to.
Feel.
Yeah. It just feels like somebody's pinching on your stomach.
Yeah, it feels very strange. It doesn't hurt.
I'll get one.
It does not hurt.
It doesn't hurt.
Really,
okay. All right.
Doesn't hurt.
I've got...
You can get one, quit it.
I'll go in like that.
Go in with your belly all pooched out. You're not going to get it still. They're going to weigh you. Paul Rubin finds work in Comedy Central.
Yeah, what is he doing?
Joining the cast of Reno 911 in its third season. He'll be playing a guardian angel.
Is that one of your favorites ever?
Oh, that's a great show. He
puts it upon himself.
Have you never seen it?
To fight local crime.
I don't think so.
Are you serious? Oh, it's almost like a tongue-in-cheek sort of sitcom. I mean, you can tell they ad-lib a lot, and they make up a lot of their lines. And it's sort of in a cop's motif, but it's campy. It's very, very, very funny. He'll do great on that show.
Okay. All right.
Brad Pitt and Jennifer Aniston broke up over her insecurities.
I figured that one.
Yeah.
She was talking about having plastic surgery. I think, was it on her nose? Chin. There was something she wasn't happy about it with her face, and I think it was her nose.
Jesus.
Just to keep Brad Pitt happy.
Can you imagine somebody that's in that great a shape, that's so attractive and probably the best they've ever looked, being insecure?
Yeah,
it's just
nutty.
Absurd.
Do you think I should go to a psychiatrist for this?
I think that would be more helpful, possibly, than going to the Cooper Clinic, because I don't think going to the Cooper Clinic is going to
help. I was happy when I weighed 170.
No, you weren't.
Yes, I was.
No, you weren't.
Yes, I was.
Then why did you start working
out? Exactly.
Because I thought I was going to build muscle. I didn't realize it came with fat.
So the number, if you go to Cooper Clinic and the number comes up 13%, which you know is low, that wouldn't erase all any kind of thought of fat. If it comes up, you're 13%.
No, and here's the problem. Even if it did for a moment,
yeah,
in time, Russ would start thinking, gee, I'm getting fat. I'm getting fat. You know, a month could go by.
That's
and,
true.
Oh, you know, I'm putting on weight. It's your head where all this from which emanates.
And that's actually a condition. It's called body dysmorphia.
I understand. But I see my body the way it is.
No, you don't.
I'm not saying that you don't, but at the very least, it could be part of body dysmorphia is you're never happy with it, even if you think it looks good. And that's just another...
I've been happy with it before. I just started working out. I didn't realize building muscle also meant building fat.
Well, here's the other thing, though. Before you started working out, did you get your body fat tested before you started working out?
Yeah, I think it was like 16%.
And you're now at 13%.
Probably 12 now.
Well, see, there you go. Even though you were thinner before you started working out, you had a higher body fat percentage. Now
maybe,
you
maybe
muscle.
Not. My skin could have been flabbier.
See, knowing that, having objective data pointed out to you didn't help, which is why going to the Cooper Clinic is
I was happy before. I'm not happy now. I've been happy. Happiness doesn't dwell here.
But it should.
But it doesn't. Happiness has moved on.
But you should endeavor to locate it.
Well, if I could knock off probably 10, 12 pounds, I'd be happy.
No, you wouldn't.
Yes, I would. I was happy when I was that weight before.
No, you weren't, or you wouldn't have started working out.
I started working out to get tone, definition.
Because you weren't happy with your current physique.
No, I was happy with where I was. I wanted to improve. I didn't improve. I got fat.
You didn't get fat. You don't lift weights every day for a year and a half or 2 years and get fat. Thin.
That's why I have to wear moo-moos.
I pay money to see you in a moo-moo. Yeah, I swear to God.
How are we doing, Chloe?
Kurt Cobain's new hometown got a new welcome sign. You care?
Got bullet holes in it?
No. Well, the old one did.
Did it really?
His Aberdeen was Washington has erected a new welcome sign to pay tribute to Kurt. The old sign, "Welcome to Aberdeen," was rusted and had bullet holes in it. So a handful of people made up a new. They got $750 together, and it just says "Come as you are," and it's dedicated to Kurt Cobain. Jennifer Lopez says it's time to simplify her life, sell the big house, and move into a cozy one.
I'm thinking about doing that.
Oh God, you just moved into the mansion.
I'm thinking of liquidating.
She says she came for virtually nothing, so there was a time when I said, oh my God, I can have a car or I can have this coat. But you get to the point where you want to strip down. I'm going to sell that big museum-type house and get a nice cozy house. I'm going to have one car and trade in all the others. That's not you. Quit it. Not even. Paris Hilton thinks she's a self-made woman.
Yeah, you got to read that.
Paris Hilton.
Now, she's modeled before, right?
Yes.
So a lot of the money could be from what she's made.
Yeah, but
that's what she says.
All right.
She even compares herself to her great-grandfather, Conrad Hilton, who started the Hilton Hotel Empire. When he dreamed of starting the hotels, he was poor, and he made it all on his own. I've made all my own money. I haven't taken anything from my family in years. I appreciate that my dad taught us to be independent. There's a lot of ambition in my family. Everybody appreciates what we have. I want to make my family name bigger than it ever was.
That didn't come off as retarded as I thought it would.
Yeah, the headline is what grabbed you.
Well, she modeled and she made her own money and she didn't take anything from the family. Had she been a dog, she would have had taken money from the family.
But had it been?
It worked out that she was hot.
Yeah. had her name been Paris Smith.
But if she was hot, she might have still been able to model,
maybe.
Nah, you're right. That wouldn't happen.
Well, it's. I think the disparity lies between, the, as you said, J.D., the headline and the content.
Right. Now. But you're right. If you piece the two of them together, you got a chick with family heritage.
Right.
Who happens to be hot, which makes her a socialite.
True.
Yeah. So, yeah, you tag all that together.
I don't really care. The guy who killed Don Beg Darrell was pulled off the stage at a Damage Plan concert 8 months previously before he killed him. Nathan
Gale. So what did this guy just go from concert to concert? Wait, now, I wonder if he tried to do the shooting before.
I don't know. This was back in December. He jumped on the stage once before, 8 months prior to the murder in April. Damage Plan was playing at a club called Bogart's in Cincinnati when Gale got on the stage while struggling with security. They were trying to pull him off stage. He did about $1,800 in damage. They pulled him out. The band didn't want to call the cops because they thought, you know, that's going to be a police report. We're going to have to come back and testify.
So they let him off.
They let him off.
All right.
Eminem's advice to 50 Cent?
No, I don't care.
All right. Miss USA talks about using Preparation H on her body.
Damn. Where?
All over.
On the belly?
All over.
They make you look tight?
That's what she says. That's cut number three.
How are we doing, Chloe? What cut?
Chelsea Cooley, cut number three, says she uses Preparation H to produce puffiness all over her body.
If you're worried about being a little bloated or a little puffiness, you take Preparation H. You rub it on any area that you feel might be a little bloated or puffy. For me, it would be my thighs and my butt and my stomach area, so I got quite a big area to cover.
When do you do this? Before the night before?
You do it the night before, yes, and then you sleep in pantyhose. So you know the whole saran wrap thing that they used to talk about? Okay, well, that's out. We've updated it to pantyhose now.
Pantyhose
right.
And Preparation H.
Right, and you wake up in the morning and you feel all skinny, and it's so nice.
There you go. That's why I pulled it.
You're cured.
I'm doing that this weekend.
Just see you tonight.
How do I get the pantyhose?
I don't know how you get them around your middle. That's the only thing. Unless you get control top.
What do you just... How far up does that go?
I don't know. I've never tried them on.
We'll be back to the Russ Martin Show.
What was the question you asked me?
Are you going to try the shirt on?
No.
Why?
No.
Come on.
This shirt doesn't fit me.
It does. And
I've figured out the scam here. You guys got somebody to call from a fake workout place and said, hey, we got this shirt, this magical shirt. If you put it on, you can bench press another 10, 15%. And then you bring in this dog sweater. Which that's exactly what this looks like. I knew there was something yesterday that wasn't clicking to where I could describe this. It looks like a dog sweater for a beagle. That's exactly the dimensions on this thing.
I know. It does. Absolutely. But it's
you hold it like this, and if somebody walked in and went, hey, what is this? You go, okay, that's a sweater for a dog. Because the arms are really close, they're short, they're really tight in the front, and then it's got a long torso. It's a dog sweater. And then you put workout on the outside of it, and you went, put this on.
As wonderful.
It's the greatest scam you guys have ever pulled.
As wonderful and entertaining as that would have been, and I wish I'd done it, but we didn't.
We're not that good.
That's a real one.
We all wish we were.
No, Mally went to his buddy last night and figured out. Did he show you how to put that on?
Yeah, the guy that called in yesterday was giving us a direction, turning it inside out. I saw him today, and he actually demonstrated one. I mean, it wasn't an actual bench shirt. It was just a regular T-shirt, but he showed me and everything. So I haven't...
How much easier does it make by turning it inside out?
It makes it a little bit easier because, for one, you'll be able to get your arms in first almost completely by yourself.
Okay.
And then we implement the unrolling of the condom
shirt.
Yes. From there. Basically, we get your arms in first.
Are you sure this is the right size for me?
Yes. They're supposed to be tight. That's the whole point.
This isn't tight. This is unbearable.
It's
absurd.
It's only unbearable when you get your face stuck in it.
I would be locked up in prison for 2 or 3 years if I had to put this on an Iraqi prisoner.
Yeah.
It doesn't stretch. I mean, I got a hold of the neck right here. It doesn't move.
No.
It's not supposed to.
It's got the consistency of a dive suit, but it just doesn't stretch.
That's a dive suit, yes, stretches. I don't even know what this material is. Just the label inside says HPHD Blast shirt.
That's also a lower end shirt. They have some that are higher end.
Yeah.
That would be
easier to get on?
No, possibly harder.
Oh. Oh, so they got a bunch of free radio and they give me the low end shirt that I can't even get on.
It's not a low end shirt. It's more like one for beginners.
Training shirt.
Yes.
Look at this.
I know. I see that. But it
for me to get in this would be a magic trick.
You almost had it on yesterday.
Here are where the shoulders are. You see where I'm pinching it with my fingers on both hands?
I see.
You see where my shoulders are in real life?
I see.
They don't mash in that far.
Yes, they did yesterday.
No, they didn't.
You had it almost on. It was down below your nipples.
It was down below my nipples, and that was as far as it was going. Rob got to my ribs, and that's when it stopped giving. And then Rob's yanking down on it, and that's when I felt my spine tweak.
Got to be a right way to get it on. It's not supposed to be easy, or it wouldn't give you the magic lifting power.
And, Dan, could you explain to me again how this magical shirt works?
This, I mean, besides the pixie dust?
Keeps the dog warm.
I got to what is the website? I mean, I haven't tried this yet. I hate to plug anything if it doesn't work. But I'm tired of describing this. I want somebody to see what it looks like.
I'll find one for you.
Hey, you don't got to do it now. We'll wait and see if it works. But that's the best description I can come up with is a great big long beagle sweater.
Yeah.
And you know what? It's about the same size that you'd put on a dog, and I got to stretch into this, or it's got to stretch onto me.
Right.
What about baby oil? Wouldn't that help?
I don't like the idea of that. I mean...
Well, that would slick everything up.
It would slick everything up, but I don't know how well that would do as far as any air bubbles in the shirt, because air bubbles in a shirt like that are bad.
Why?
Because if you have an air bubble across your chest and you drop the bar on the bubble, it'll kick back and smack you in the face.
If the bar gets that down to my chest, that far, air bubbles ain't my problem. Rob? What are you doing?
Looking for employment.
Why?
I got to get a part-time job.
Yeah, I heard about that from JD. What, and I ain't buying this either, so...
That's...
No, it's not.
All right.
What about baby oil?
I talked to three people today, and they said the baby oil was not a good idea because everybody's going to slip trying to pull the shirt on, and the shirt is just going to stick to your skin.
Yeah, you want to dry it a little bit.
So we stick with the baby powder?
Yeah, just... powder on your back, under your arms, and stuff like that.
Just so you know it's real, there's the website.
I don't mean nothing.
We didn't create a website.
I don't know. This could be very elaborate.
It doesn't say powered by VertBiz on the bottom of it.
No.
Yeah, you're right. All right, so how does this make me lift, or how does this make anybody lift
heavier weight?
Yeah.
It's
do I want to take line 5 before we go on with this?
Yeah. That's the guy with the business card with the number that called in.
Okay. Hi, Aaron.
Hey.
What do you got?
What's up, Grand Dragon?
Hello.
What do you got, Aaron?
I got I don't have it. My girlfriend has it. I called her up to verify what it was. It says in big red letters, Russ Martin. Underneath that, in small text, well, you know, big enough where you can read it, says radio host.
Yeah.
Underneath that, it has the phone number I gave Dan.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
And is there a way that you can scan that or get that card to me?
When I get out of work.
Okay.
And it's... Say CBS or KLLI.
It just says radio host.
Yeah.
What if that's enough to pop that bastard?
Should be. Unless he, by chance, has a radio show somewhere we don't know of. It says the call letters, he's dead in the water. But it just says radio host.
Did not say anything else about CBS or anything on it?
Nope.
Mm-hmm.
I made sure to ask about that because I've been listening.
All right. Yeah, if you could scan that and get that to me, I'll we'll go from there.
I can, but I have a request for me to do that. JD's got to get naked.
When?
No.
Yeah, okay.
Okay.
Ooh, look at the size of that. Big and beefy. Ah, look at the veins. All right, it's out.
Yep.
Give me the card. trying this? Do we still have baby powder?
Yeah, right over here.
This will be fun.
It's not fun.
Get on. All kinds of stuff here. They got erector shirts, bench shirts, squat suits, deadlift suits.
I don't know how you get that far into it. I mean, I'm okay with the working out and, you know, seeing the benefits and feeling a little bit better at it because, you know, mm-hmm. you did something worthwhile. Sure. But as far as all the T-shirts and the fingerless gloves and everything else, or the belts.
How do people get into anything else? Golf. Look at all the accoutrements of golf. There's a zillion things, you know, you just get so far off into a sport, you know, you got to have the certain kind of, you know, fishing, any sport. They just, people get whacked off into it.
I suppose. What, Dan? No. What?
It's a different mentality from the working out that you do and say I do, right. And even Rob for that matter. We're not power lifters to the extent where we want a suit like that because we would like to see how much we could bench by adding one of those. It wouldn't surprise me if we got one of those on Rob if he's throwing up 505 instead of 405.
Oh, I wouldn't doubt it. If these things work, and I still don't understand the mechanics behind it.
We'll get it on you. You'll do it.
Okay.
And you'll see.
All right. So if I'm lifting now 2 1/4, 250 should be no problem.
Yeah.
So I go out there and do the 250, and the bet with Larry North is off, and we're done. Because he didn't say nothing about wearing no magical shirts.
No, he didn't.
Well, there's the problem I see with this is...
I can't get it on!
Other than that, I think we're almost there.
Okay.
I don't believe this is my size. I really don't.
I don't know. They measured you.
What does 50 mean on this, Dan? Do you know? On the tag?
That I don't know. Sorry.
All right. Why don't you come in here first and see, can I squeeze into the magical shirt? Who's on the hotline? Who's on the hotline?
It's a Chris T guy from Boise, Idaho, the strip club.
Oh, tell him to hold on, I'm dressing. Just get rid of him and come in here and help me.
Sure you don't want me to do the bar first?
No, why?
Because you're going to want that thing on and off.
What's the use of doing the bar if I can't get in the shirt?
Because I'd rather have that done, so it's done. Because you're going to walk right out and want to do it. We're going to get the shirt on.
Can I breathe in this thing or not?
Yeah, but you're going to go right to the door and do it.
Then shouldn't he be pumping up?
No, what do you do? You go through the lower weights with this on.
Yeah, we'll do 185 first, so you get used to it.
Oh, okay, I got you.
Do a quick warm-up, you get used to it,
and we'll throw you on. How do you know for sure this is the right size for me?
Based on the measurements that we took yesterday, that is the 50 is the size that you're supposed to wear.
Somebody swear to me that this is real.
I swear. Sure, I even looked up the website.
That don't make any difference. Everybody's got a website. Do we need a break? All right. What are you going to put on the bar to start? 185?
185.
Okay. And then we're going to squeeze me into this.
Yes.
And then we'll go to 185, 2 1/4.
I would say more than...
I'd just do it.
Yeah. Just go from 185 straight to 250?
Yeah. Why mess around?
All right.
You want something to eat?
I've already eaten.
All right. You want some ephedrine?
This is the Russ Martin Show.
Are you guys ready for this?
Yeah.
What's the matter with you?
Nothing. I'm just going to go grab my camera phone.
No. Come on. Your camera phone?
Yeah. Oh, never mind. Rob's got one.
I don't think
I'll... Just...
Are you ready?
Yeah.
I'm going to powder this up real quick.
You going to powder the shirt and not me?
Well, both.
Okay.
Push down. Zoom there. Push down there.
Okay.
All right, so I'm going to do my arms straight out like this, and then what, tuck my head down?
You won't have to tuck your head down until we're ready to put your head down.
I'm just going to stand here and you guys tell me what to do.
That'll work.
All right. You ready?
Yeah. How are you up?
Keep your hand on the delay.
All right.
Oh.
Powder being put on?
Don't be shooting that.
Why?
I don't want anybody to see that.
Why?
I don't want you to.
You've been working out your buff.
I don't want you to.
Oh, please. Fucking pop rosin.
Cool.
Are we ready?
Yep.
All right. What am I doing?
All right. Put your arms in the sleeve holes.
All right. They're in.
Okay. Now, Rob, let's just kind of pull him up to close to his bicep as we can.
Okay. Okay. All right, the sleeves are on. Is that as far up as they go?
We're going to try.
This is not the right shirt. This is wrong. Okay. Now what?
Now are you going to duck his head?
Yeah, let's do his head.
Wait. And my nose! Is that going on my stomach?
Well, they got it going.
I'm gonna faint!
She put his arms up or
squirming. It's not going on!
Yeah, do the Superman. There you go.
Okay, oh, alright. We're doing good.
Ready?
Ready, Dan?
Hold on. Let's pull the sleeve
over.
Pull it back.
Okay,
that's good. It's
right, a triangle shoulder. It's not going over my shoulder.
Yeah, it is.
Alright, thanks. Alright.
Ready?
Wait. Let me breathe for a second. Hold on.
I'm gonna dry your sweat off.
I get my. Alright.
Ready?
Now wait! What's the matter, John?
The battery's dying.
Oh,
I'm letting it rest
right.
While you're taking a rest.
All right.
Ready?
Yeah.
3, 2, 1.
Almonds!
Almost there!
You're so close.
It's not going down. It's not on. I can't.
Don't say it again.
Okay. Almonds!
Here we go.
It's not going over my chest. It's not.
It's almost there.
Oh, my God.
Oh, look how close.
Oh,
they got it.
You're breaking my
heart. No, they got it.
It's so close. It's killing me.
Look, you got it.
Faint.
No, you're not close.
Faint. My nipple's stuck in there.
Almost.
Don't breathe. Do breathe.
All right. All right,
now we just got to hold the shoulders.
All right.
You're in almost.
No, I'm not.
You're in. You can see yourself.
Well, look at me. Here we go.
Yeah, that's my fat. I'm pushing it in. I mean it.
All right. That's good.
That's not on.
Okay, try to put your arms down. There you go.
This is not the right shirt.
Your arms don't go down now.
They don't go down.
That looks painful. That seriously looks painful.
I didn't stop.
Back off. We're cutting this bitch off.
This is not.
This is. Bro, quit yanking on me like that.
This is not the right shirt.
Yes, it is.
All right then.
Robo man.
Oh, that's the best ever.
Let's go pump some iron.
You look so ridiculous.
Is this it?
Well,
This is not all the way on.
Well, it looks like
I can't breathe. It's cutting off the center. I really can't
breathe. He's got a midriff going still.
Somebody pull my pants up.
He can't reach his own pants.
Pull my pants.
That'd be the perfect time. There you go. Yeah, he's got a midriff going.
Seriously, I can't feel anything in my arms.
Because you keep holding the
button. Well, then you can't press the wave.
No.
Okay. They got almost all the way down there. It's looking better. Whatever he's doing is working.
Yeah. We're just.
Because you're not looking. Quit yanking on his neck. Yeah, you were looking bad there for a second. I mean, you were looking like you just needed surgery. Look, I do.
Well, seriously, we're cutting this back off.
When I put my shoulder out, that's how you looked. It can't be good for your muscles.
Down the side a little bit here.
This is the worst day in my life.
The worst day in your life.
Oh. Okay, you ready? This is the way it's supposed to be?
Oh, Rob, seriously.
This is absurd.
That's right.
That just looks...
He just slapped
him. Slapped him
out of O'Malley.
This is wrong.
He just slapped him in the face because he laughed at him. That looks painful.
It's not. It's because it's the wrong shirt.
No, it's not.
It is.
Well, he got it on you.
It's just because it's...
Okay. Don't... Seriously.
All right, then.
No. No, all right, then.
No, I can't. I can't even. No! It's
I'll
the
keep
wrong.
Going down.
I don't want you to go down.
That's all we can do.
This shirt is too small.
Nope. Rob knows.
John?
Yeah.
I don't care who I am.
Oh, God, that's funny. Oh, Jesus, man. That seriously looks like your shoulder is out of
here.
Socket. Pulling down on your arm.
I have no blood.
No.
Blood.
Quit with the doll. The rag doll.
Oh, there's nothing I can do. It's like I can't feel any circulation in my arms.
If you're serious, then just come
serious.
Off. We'll just cut it off.
People don't wear this on purpose.
Rob, seriously, that
whatever
looks
it
like
is.
Your shoulder's out of socket.
It I know is. My shoulder's out of socket.
I know it's not out of socket.
You what?
Don't hit
my
Rob.
My shoulder's out of the socket.
No, it's not.
Whatever it is you want to know, I'll tell you.
You'd know.
Just cut me out.
You'd know if it was out
this
of
is,
socket.
This is, no, I can't. I can't move. All right, cut it off me.
Oh, cool.
I can't feel anything right here. Okay, that's how it's supposed to be. I want to feel. I'm serious.
Okay.
And I'm not going back through this to get it off. Cut off the back of it.
Oh, you're not even trying to
burst
away?
I can't move.
But try.
Don't cut me, Rob.
Try to do one.
Well, stop, Rob. Well, look. I can't go beyond this. And
what happens if you do?
That's how it's supposed to be.
It'll snap my arms off.
No. Just go through the motion with 185. And I'll stay over the bar.
Just
go through the motion.
I'll stay in here with
you. And then you'll cut it off.
Yeah. Unless you say don't because you want to do 250. We've got this far.
You don't cut this thing off of me, and you ain't living in that house with me.
Okay.
All right. Get the scissors and let's go.
All right.
Hey, Chloe, open
the... Okay.
JD, run the board.
All right. So nobody's saying nothing because I got to walk over there.
What is that? Is the mic out there?
Yeah.
Oh. JD, run the board.
I got it. Open the blinds for me. I'm sorry. Dear God. How come I can't hear myself?
Will somebody please pull my pants up? John?
I'm here now. I hear you.
All right,
turn
me a little bit.
Okay, where is he? Oh, that was funny.
I can't move my arms apart. Are you ready? All right, this is just 185.
185.
Here's
the thing. I can hear you just fine, yes.
To go through the motion.
All right,
lift it up.
Ready?
Yeah. All right.
Up.
All right. Let's break it. Nuh-uh. It's
okay.
Cut my armpits.
It's
cutting right
there?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. It's
that's
too what small.
They said it was. Cutting in the armpits.
All right, cut me out of it.
Oh.
I can't bend right here.
Okay. We're doing something wrong then.
Oh, thank you.
There it goes.
Just cut it.
Like a car wreck victim. He does. It looks like he's been in a motorcycle accident.
Don't move.
And the EMTs are cutting him out.
All right. Quiet. No, nothing. Very good.
There it is. He's out. Okay.
Weasel. Salespeople are out there.
Of course.
Oh, pull this. Oh, thank you. Enjoy yourself?
That was fun. It seriously looked like you'd been in some kind of an accident and they were cutting you out. It's the way your shoulders were pulled forward. That's exactly how I looked when I was in the emergency room. I don't know.
Could you feel the difference?
Oh, God.
I couldn't. The crease wasn't... All right. The easiest way I can explain this is you would think the crease would go where my armpits are, right?
Right.
Okay. Where the fold would be in the shirt?
Mm-hmm.
The fold in the shirt was the middle of my biceps. Which means it wasn't pulled up all the way on. That makes sense?
Yes.
Which goes back and reinforces the point I was trying to make earlier.
It's the wrong size!
How long did we spend trying to get me in that?
About 12 minutes.
16.
And was it worth it?
It was. When I show you the pictures.
I don't want to see the pictures. Oh, I want those to vanish.
No, they won't. Okay, they'll vanish. On my website.
We'll be back to the Russ Martin Show.